Alright, two more examples here. Solve these inequalities. Okay, I'm just going to change this one. Make number 4 an inequality. There we go. Okay, so number 3. 4 times x minus 3 is less than 5x plus 1. The first thing we do, of course, is distribute, just like with an equation. Everything's the same except for that one step of flipping that sign around if we need to. Okay, so I distribute the 4, so I get 4x minus 12 is less than 5x plus 1. Then I'm going to add 12 to both sides. Okay, so that those go away, so it leaves me with 4x on the left is less than 5x plus 13. I'm going to subtract 5x from both sides. x minus 5x is negative 1x, or negative x. That's gone, and that should be less than positive 13. Okay, remember, we want x by itself. There's a 1 here. If you want, you can put a 1. It's negative 1. And we're going to divide both sides by that coefficient of x. So divide both sides by negative 1. That goes away. And it leaves with x is greater than, flip the sign, because we just because we divided by that negative. So I got to flip the sign in this example. In the last example, we didn't do that. But in this one, I have to. And 13 divided by negative 1 is negative 13. And there's my answer. X is greater than negative 13. Okay. One more example. This one we're going to graph as well. Those directions solve and graph, so I'm going to graph it after I solve. We've already done some graphing. So same process. I'm going to subtract 13 from both sides. Leaves me with 2x is greater than or equal to 7x minus 25. That's a 7. And then, of course, I subtract 7x from both sides. Notice how I always like to get my x's on the left-hand side of the inequality. I think it just makes it a little bit easier. You don't have to do that, but I think it makes it easier because usually when you read an inequality, it always starts with x. On the left-hand side is greater than or less than, and then the number on the right-hand side. Okay, so 2x minus 7x, negative 5x, the sign. Notice I haven't flipped the sign because I haven't divided yet, right? So there's no need. I did subtract, but I don't flip sign when I subtract. That's gone. It's negative 25. And then I'm going to divide. Now, just because I divide doesn't mean I flip the sign, but because I divide in this example by a negative again, then that means we'll flip our sign around, okay? So divide by negative 5, it gets x by itself. Flip my sign. Less than or equal to now. And then negative 25 divided by 5, negative 5 is positive 5, okay? So now in this case, I'm going to have to go one further step and graph it. X is less than or equal to 5, so I find 5. I draw my bracket, remember this? And then I shade everything to the left, because that's where the numbers less than are. Okay, so that's everything going this way. So now you can see your answer a little bit better, and it's what I was talking about before. That's a little crooked. It's okay. That you don't just have one answer for these, right? An inequality means a bunch of numbers. That's x is less than 5. That's the solution set. It's all these numbers going back less than 5 all the way forever, and including that number 5. Okay? So you have some practice to do. Do some practice problems, and then do some more practice problems.